Oh my god! This is a strong power assist device! Oh my god! I would probably just buy this only for this feature. So comfortable. Hey, what's up? Sam here. Today, we are checking out something futuristic. The wearable power knee exoskeleton. This is a wearable device designed to reduce knee stress, boost endurance, and make uphill climbs or downhill descents a lot easier. I put through some serious tests, including with the Cosmic K5 monitoring system and the Delsys AMG measurement system, which measure real energy expenditure and muscle activation. So we got hard numbers to back up the experience. Well, a super important note before we begin. Wearable was very clear that the final mass production version will be significantly optimized. Things like surface finish and craftsmanship, battery capacity, and lighter materials to make it more comfortable. But even this early version shows incredible potential. Let's get started with the basics. Let's start with the design. Here's the belt for your waist. We see two batteries here. Just press this button to take the battery out and just to install it. And with the two batteries combined, it will give you about 5 hours of continuous use. Turn to the front, we have some cushions here, which feels really comfortable. Okay, let me show you how to wear it. There's a buckle here, and just buckle it. Okay, that's it. And this strap here can always be adjusted, and then you can just like that. Looks neat, right? And now let's move down a little bit. And here we have two parts. And this pad is obviously for your thighs, and this is for the calves. Okay, and this is the motor. We'll talk about that a little bit later. So let's just wheel it like that. And for this part, you have to make sure the motor is at the same level as your knee. This will give you the best result, okay? I think they're the same. And then, buckle up. Here's the thing, there's one more pad here. So you have to fix it here with two more straps here to fix the whole exoskeleton more firmly. Of course, the length of this belt is also adjustable. But for me, it's all right, okay? That's how you wear for your left leg. And now let's get to the other leg. It's the same way to wear it. And that's how you wear it. It literally just took me like 30 seconds, I think. Woo! And that's how you wear it. So, is it comfortable to wear? Well, I'd say yes. Each side weighs just around 650 grams. So it feels almost weightless. One robot told me that the wheel, you know, adopts more lightweight materials like carbon fiber or something. But I really feel this is not bad, my first impression. It won't interfere with your movement at all. And it's designed to fit users from 155 centimeters to 195 centimeters tall and between 50 kilograms and 120 kilograms. I happen to be in this range and I believe most of you are too. And it feels stable, secure, and natural. Now, let's just power the thing on. And this is the motor. We see there are three buttons here. Just press and hold the power key to turn it on. The indicator just lights up. And we press the plus or minus to choose different, you know, power assistance. And that's it. Okay, since it's on, let me just walk a little bit on this flat ground. Okay. yeah. I can definitely feel some sort of power assistance, like on your thighs and the calves. I can definitely feel it, but seems like not that noticeable. But that makes sense, because when you're working on a flat surface, your knees don't really take that much impact, right? So I like to test it on uphill and downhill slopes. Let's start by trying without wearing the power knee. Without power knee, I had to take small, cautious steps. The impact on my knees feel sharp, and my pace slowed naturally because I didn't want to trip, you know? Be careful. Oh my God. That's my cameraman almost got tripped, you know. And when going up here, I can feel like my thighs burned quickly and lifting my legs are started to feel heavy after just a few dozen steps. No, with power knee. Everything's ready. Let's just see how it goes. Let's go. All right. Oh my God. That's really cool. I think this going up here is where this power knee shines because you can feel the power that's applied to your thighs and calves like instantly, like really push you really, really hard. Every leg lifting is much, much easier. I can confidently say lifting my legs was noticeably easier, muscle soreness was reduced, and the climb felt smoother. And now, let's go down here. Now down here with power knee on, my strides are way longer, my pace faster, and my knees felt, especially my knees felt much more stable. It absorbs much of the impact, so even on long distance, I will feel lighter, safer, and more confident. Because you know there's a support. There is a support behind your legs. So you will be more confident and... Now here's things get really interesting. I want more than just it feels easier. So I use the Cosmic K5 system, which measures oxygen intake and carbon dioxide output to calculate real energy expenditure. For this part, let me quickly walk you through the process, just in case you're curious. Honestly, a little bit ridiculous. Suit up like it's the end of the world. So if you only care about the final result, feel free to skip ahead about a minute. This was my first time testing the exoskeleton in a way that gives quantifiable scientific data, not just some personal feelings. I have to strap on the Cosmic K5 system. Basically, it's like wearing a small backpack with a snug mask on my face, kind of like an alien cosplay. The system measures my breathing and energy use in real time with built-in sensors. Then sends all the data wirelessly to the laptop I was holding, where the software records everything. The test itself was simple. Walk the same 10-minute route with and without the power knee exoskeleton, then compare the results. Now, the raw data looks overwhelming, but here's the simple takeaway. When wearing the power knee, my energy expenditure dropped by 24%. I honestly didn't know what to expect, so seeing that number was a real surprise. Put another way, every 100 steps I took only feel like about 76 in terms of effort. In addition to energy data, I also use Theraset's AMG system, which tracks muscle activity. This gave me a direct look at how much my quads and hamstrings were actually working with and without assistance. The results line up perfectly with the K5 data, lower muscle activation with power knee, meaning less fatigue and longer endurance. What I really want to test is the small mouse. I know one of the hardest challenges in developing products like this is tuning the strut algorithm, making sure it follows your step naturally instead of interfering, tripping you, or feeling out of sync. That's why the smart mode stood out to me. Power knee is just one mode fits all. It has four smart modes for different scenarios: AI adaptive boost mode, resistance training mode, massage mode, and this mode is probably the best I love. After a long hike or gym session, it gently relaxes your leg muscles. I tried this after a couple of hours of hiking, and the relief was real. And that's the four smart modes. You can either switch between them by pressing the button here or through the app. And speaking of that, let's talk a little bit more about the app. All right, so here's the interface, and here we see force. That means how much force they applied to you, and distance and time. Also, we have the battery indicator, and unknown means, you know, the mode you are in. Currently, I'm standing, not moving, so it's unknown. And moving down a little bit, we have the auto free workout and relax mode, the four small modes, and then you can press the plus or minus key here to adjust the power resistance and the power knee. And that is basically the app, quite straightforward. And yeah, that's it. Let me just walk it, you see? Working now, it's working now. And yeah, quite accurate actually. So that is basically the app. I hope they told me this is like the first version and they will add more features in the future. So that's the app. Now my conclusion. Though I had limited time with this device and it's still in prototype stage, I'm impressed by how polished it already feels. It effectively reduces knee pressure on descents, provides a powerful boost on ascents, and a significant cost on energy expenditure. The Cosmate K5 data proves that it's not just a feeling, it's measurable. I like the smart modes, especially the massage mode. I also appreciate how powerful the motor feels when going uphill. The straps are fully adjustable, easy to wear, and comfortable to fit. I'm also impressed by the motor, small but super strong. The power boost is amazing, yet it remains super silent. You should check it out. If you ask me about the downsides, I would probably say the weight and the size. Right now, it feels bulky and not very compact, which could be a deal breaker for some people. The app is still in its early stages and sometimes has mode recognition bugs. But overall, this prototype already feels very complete. So for hikers, outdoor adventurers, or even commuters dealing with the stairs every day, I think Pioneer is worth paying attention to. If you are interested, please check the link in the description to learn more. And let me know in the comments, would you use something like this for your hikes or daily commutes? Thanks for watching, Samuel. See you in the next one. Bye-bye.